Okay, good evening guys. Welcome to one more floriculture session on types of gardening. I hope my voice is clear and the screen is visible now.
Yes.
Okay, then we can start the class now. Types of gardening. Mainly, there are only three basic styles in the gardening. One is formal and informal, and one more is wild garden. This was the recent one. Coming to formal gardens. Formal gardens means these are all mainly laid out in symmetrical or geometrical pattern. Hence, these are also called as symmetrical or geometrical gardens. Then this garden has the this garden design is stiff and rigid. This has to follow some rigid rules and pattern. So it is symmetrical in nature and everything is planned in the straight lines. Hence it is called formal type. Then mirror image of each other. If you consider, if you plant a Ashoka tree in the left hand side of your road, and the similar plant should be planted in the right side also. This will form the mirror image. Then coming to flower beds, borders, shrubbery are also arranged in the geometrical designed beds. If you visit any other gardens, if the flower beds, they are arranged in the square or rectangular or any other geometrical shapes, those are all formal gardens. Then trimmed flower edges, cypress, Ashoka, topiary, these are all the typical features of formal garden. You need to remember this one. These are all the important points. Trimmed former edges, cypress. Cypress usually used in the formal garden because this is mainly used for the topiary purpose. This is undergoes for the trimming. They will form the geometrical shapes. Like that, you need to remember the bullet points of formal gardens. Then coming to informal garden styles, the whole design looks informal as the plan and the features are arranged in the natural without following any hard and fast rules. Here we will not follow any rules. We will not plan the garden in straight lines or any geometrical shapes. Hence it is called natural style. But here also the work has to be proceed according to the set and well thrown out plan. Otherwise, the creation will not create the aesthetic or attractive garden. Here also, we will go for the well planned set of patterns in the garden to create a more aesthetic beauty. But here, we will not follow any geometrical shapes or any rules, unlike in formal garden. The main idea behind this design is to imitate the nature. This is an important statement, to imitate the nature. Then it tries to produce the natural effect in the garden. Informal gardens are rural type or natural effect will be shown in the informal gardens. Then suited for the place of countryside where the villa or house is small and situated in one side of the large area. This is the suitability where we can apply the informal garden style. Then coming to one more, wild garden. Wild garden, comparatively, this is a recent type of gardening. This is also called as wild gardening. Why? Who first named this wild gardening? The William Robinson. You need to remember William Robinson for wild gardening. Then the concept of wild garden is not only against all the formalism, but also breaks the rules of landscape styles which you are followed in the informal type. It will not follow the landscape styles which were followed in the formal and informal type. Hence it is called as wild gardening. His main idea is to naturalize the plants in shrubberies. Then he also preached that the grass should be remain unmowed. We should not cut the grass as it is in nature, and few bulbous plants should be grown scattered in the grasses to imitate the wild scenery. This is the main idea behind the wild gardens. Then further, there is no garden style called Indian garden. This is also important type, because in the multiple choice type questions, they will give the option like Indian garden. There is no garden called Indian garden style, so you can easily eliminate this option. And further, the major, coming to major garden styles, these are all the major gardens which we have already dealt with, and these are all the garden styles which they were followed. You remember English and Japanese styles, these are all the informal type. They don't follow any rules and regulations, unlike the other guys. The English and Japanese will don't follow any other rules and regulations, hence they were informal. Other were formal type. Coming to Mughal types, the gardens laid out by the Mughal emperors mainly. Here, these are similar to Central Asia and Persia region. These Mughals were come from Central Asia and Persia, mountain regions of Central Asia and Persia to India. Babur was the first Mughal emperor ruled. This ruler introduced this style to India. Babur. You need to remember his name, Babur. After that, Akbar, Jahangir, Noor Jahan, Shah Jahan, Aurangzeb, other rulers put their hands in developing the many gardens in India. Then further, the main features are site and style selection, then walls, gates, garden, naharas. Naharas means running water bodies. Then baradari, this is the structures, tomb-like structures. Then the tomb, mosques and the trees. Coming to site and design, in Mughals, they prefer the site on the hilly slope with the perennial rivers or along with the river banks. Then the gardens will mainly rectangle or square in shape, hence they are formal. Coming to walls and gates, these Mughals created the garden not only for the pleasure and recreation purpose, but also for the security. Hence they mainly use the large walls and gates imposed with the iron nails and spikes. Then further, terraces. These Mughals came from the hilly terrains, so they fond of terraces, means different heights. Terraces means different heights. Then they believe that in Islamic faith, the paradise has 8 division. Hence, sometimes the garden have the 8 terraces. We have discussed one garden related to this, which was that in Jaipur. Which garden? Which we have discussed in the last class. Which was that garden at Jaipur? Not remembering? Which is the garden located at Jaipur, built by Mughals? You need to answer for this question, because I have repeatedly told this question, this object. You need to remember this one. You remember and tell me. Okay. Then further, naharas. Naharas means running water bodies. The Mughal style have the running water body. They will construct the canals. Then the water canals are paved, means laid out with the marbles, mainly the blue colored marbles, to create the illusion of depth. Illusion of depth means, for seeing in the normal eyes, it shows the river body or the water body is too deep. It's a total internal reflection. Then further, baradari. Baradari means it is nothing but an arbor like structure. Means you consider this is a structure which consists of 12 doors. Here the emperors will sit and watch the performance of dancing ladies, girls. You remember baradari means it consists of 12 doors. Bara means kitna? 12. Then tombs and mosques. These are all the common practice to have the garden built around a tomb. Mainly, the best example is Taj Mahal, and one more is Akbar's tomb at Sikandra. Further, trees and flowers. This is also important. Here, the trees were selected with the careful planning and thought. As for the Mughals, they were these the each trees which they were selected, which symbolizes something like life, depth, youth. You consider these fruit crops. These symbolize the life and youthness in garden. Then further, cypress means death and eternity. This is important type, important objective type questions. Then further, Persian gardens. Persian garden style is one of the oldest. This is the oldest type of garden. Persian garden style and the Japanese garden styles are based on the idea of heaven. This is also important. And Persian gardens and Mughal gardens are similar. This is also formal type garden, symmetrical in nature, geometric. They also follow the geometrical pattern of garden design. They also build the gardens in the hilly slope. They will also create the natural fountain or natural river bodies. And they will also have the flowing canals. They also believe the paradise concept. Then here, the fruit trees represents the symbol of life, and the cypress represents the death and eternity. This is important. Then further, Italian gardens. Italian gardens came to existence at the time of Renaissance. Renaissance concept means it's a rebirth or revival of civilization. The important features here are, here the massive flight of stairs, generally of marbles and complete with the balustrade to connect the different levels in the garden. Then decorative urns, then fountains with a combination with the stone sculptures. These are all the main European type of gardens, Italian gardens. Then for the French garden, here the main, if you remember the French garden, you need to remember the Leonardo. He is the sole responsible. Due to his efforts, the French gardening style has been established in the world concept. He worked in the Royal Garden of Louis. Louis is a king. The main contribution of French garden is the Garden of Versailles. You remember this Garden of Versailles. This garden has been created by evacuating thousands of villages to create the vista concept in this garden. You remember this one, Garden of Versailles, from French garden style built by Leonardo under the guidance of King Louis. Then what they teach us, French gardens teach us the lesson how to think big. This is also important one. Then the style of Leonardo is an evolution and mastery of art of formal garden in its perfection. This is the style of Leonardo. You need to remember these bullet points. Further, in English gardens, the famous British gardens architects like Repton and Capability Brown, they were the two important architects. You will get these points in the match the following, or in the objective type or assertion and reasoning type of questions. So you need to remember all these personalities' name. The main idea of these gardens should merge the countryside. Means the garden should merge with the countryside. This is the main idea behind the English gardens. Then they use the without using any artificial barriers like fence hedges. Then further, the English gardens were fed with the flower beds, topiary, terrace gardens. This is nowadays also following. Then further, the main features in the English garden is lawn, mixed borders, especially herbaceous annuals, then shrubbery, rock garden. These are all the main features in English garden. This will be the definite question. The lawn, mixed border, shrubberies and rock garden, herbaceous annuals. Then the most flowering annuals used in the Indian gardens today, amaranthus, balsam, gamfarina, marigold, and many others, which were brought by Britishers. These were the contribution of Britishers. Then for the Japanese gardens. Japanese garden means which you are this Persian and Japanese mainly constructed based on the idea of heaven. This is the first point. Then the Japanese garden, this will symbolize the immutability, means unchanging or unchangeable, means there is nothing much changes in the garden except some deciduous trees. The garden hardly goes for the any strong visible changes during the different season, different seasons. That's why we call Japanese gardens are immutability or unchangeable. Then further we will discuss different types of Japanese gardens. Main important types of Japanese gardens are hill garden. Hill garden means Sukiyanama Niwa. This means hills and water. Then flat garden, Hiraniwa. Then tea garden. In tea garden also we will find outer garden like Sotoroji and inner garden like Uchiroji. And for the passage garden means Rijiniwa. This also contains lanterns and lantern basins and other man-made features. Passage garden. Then sand garden, it's totally divided of plants. This is also important point. The best or the famous example of sand garden exists in Tokyo. Ryoji garden. This is a Japanese garden. Then for the birthday anniversary of Buddha, we built a Japanese style of garden in New Delhi. Can you name that? Can you name that? Yesterday class only we dealt with it. Anybody? Buddha Jayanti Park. Then some of the important features of Japanese garden like ponds, streams, waterfall, fountain, wells. These are all the important features, and also island. And with respect to these different islands, you know, no need to remember, but these are all important. Hill garden means what is the vernacular name? Flat garden, tea gardens, these are all important one. And the features in the Japanese garden also important. It contains streams, waterfalls, fountains, wells, bridges, water basin, stone lanterns, pagoda, fences, gates. The main features will be hill garden, flat garden. These are all the different types. And also, if you remember the different types of gardens, so it is easy to remember the different features. If you could see some of the important photos on the Japanese garden, it is easy to remember the different features also. Then further I will discuss some of the important bulletins from my short notes. I will discuss or we will revise this one. And the main and the objective types are assertion, reasoning type questions will arise. The types of gardening. Mainly the in geometrical or formal or symmetrical type of garden. Here we will follow the rigid rules. The main trees used are cypress. Cypress were the main trees. Here we used Italian, Persian, Mughal, American, Rome. All these will comes under formal. In informal, this is like landscape type. No rules were followed here. The main idea is to imitate the nature. Here, the Japanese, Chinese, and English, they will mainly follow the informal garden type. For the aesthetic or freestyle or this type. Aesthetic or freestyle mainly followed by Englishes or botanical gardens became freestyle after the Britishers conquered many other countries. This is also important style, freestyle or aesthetic style. This is the combination of formal or informal style of gardening. Then further we have the wild type. Here we need to remember William Robinson.
Here the bulbs, grassland are scattered. The timbers are resembles the forest. Then here the forest trees are fulfilled with the creepers on it. It breaks the all the rules of the garden. Then further in Mughal gardens we will find the terraces, fountains, baradari, then hilly region, river flow, naharas, paradise. Six part the paradise will say six parts of Quran. This is also important one. Then here we follow the square rectangular design, and here the walls and gates are used for the protection of hot winds or enemies. Here Baradara means toll gates will be there. Tree represents the renewal of life. Then fruit represents symbolize the youth and life. Source of life will be water or naharas. Cypress symbolize death and eternity. Then world's oldest botanical garden located at Italy, Padua. You remember world's oldest botanical garden located at Italy. French garden or formal type, Leon Atre, you need to remember, landscape designer. How to think big, he showed us how to think big. Then garden of Versailles, he evacuated the seven villages to build this garden. Then coming to informal gardens like Japanese, this here the main features were mountain, waterfalls. Then here they mainly imitate the nature, peacefulness, immutability, no change are the main feature of Japanese gardens. Ponds, trees, fountain, bridges, rock, bamboo gates, these are also main features. The different style of Japanese gardens like hill garden, flat garden, tea garden, passage garden, sand garden, these are all important one. Famous sand garden is located at Kyoto. Roenji garden. Then come to English gardens, Repton and Capability Brown, they were the main landscape architects. Garden should look like countryside. This is the concept of English style of gardening. Then lawn is the main feature, herbaceous border, the main concept of Britishers. This was given by William Robinson is also comes in wild garden. Herbaceous border, rockery, cottage garden concept was given by Jekyll, J-E-K-Y-E-L-L, Jekyll. Then kitchen garden concept also given by Britishers. Then Persian, Japanese is informal, Persian is formal, but they have the common idea of paradise or heaven. Japanese have triangular shape of gardens. The fruits, flowers, arrangement will be triangular in shape. Then water garden is also important. Buddhist garden, Buddhist idea. The lotus will be associated with the lords of Brahma, Vishnu, Lakshmi. Okay. Then any other points to add for this discussion or any other doubts, queries? Yes? Ankita, Deb, Shasti. You are there? Ankita, Deb, Shasti. Are you there?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Any other points to add for this discussion? Yes, you are free to add.
Thank you.
Srishti?
So if you had some photographs of the garden, more beneficial.
Yeah, in the next class I will definitely add those.
Yes sir.
Yeah. Then further, you know where is the Nanda Devi National Park? Have you heard of Valley of Flowers, where it is located? Nanda Devi National Park is located at Uttarakhand. This is also called as Valley of Flowers. This is important one. Here, the Brahma Kamala. This is the state flower of Uttarakhand. You remember this one, Brahma Kamala. Then, if it is the case, then we will close this session. We will discuss in tomorrow.
Yes, sir.
Which class you want in the next session? Can you discuss bonsai and other concepts?
Yes sir.
Okay, then in the next class we will discuss on the bonsai and other aspects. Okay. Can you close the session now? For this, you can say yes, na? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay.